Hello, my name is Tim Bean, and welcome to the online Hazardous Waste Program, Chemical Waste Create Label tutorial. This short video will show you the process for creating a waste container label with multiple chemical constituents. Take note that upon your successful CalNet authentication, you are automatically directed to the Create Label page. In the top left corner, you will see your name. Next to Generator, you will see one of the following: your laboratory name, your department name, or your individual name. I am associated with the Office of Environment, Health, and Safety. To begin, select the Create New Label radio button. Next, select your building from the drop-down menu. I am in University Hall in room 383. If your building is not appearing on the drop-down menu item list, then enter it here. Now take note of the accumulation start date. This is the date that hazardous waste is first added to the container. It is assumed that since the label must be affixed to the container before adding waste, that the day you create a new label is the day you begin accumulating waste. This presentation shows how to create a label for chemical waste. Chemical waste exhibits flammable, toxic, corrosive, or reactive characteristics. This process is also used to create a label for waste containers that have unknown chemical constituents. Select the Chemical Waste radio button. Next, select the radio button for the physical state. The options are gas, liquid, or solid. Select liquid if any free liquid is present. For example, if there is a solid in your waste container in addition to a liquid, select liquid as the state. Following the physical state selection, you may now add a constituent to the label by clicking on the Add button. A pop-up search screen will appear. Enter the name of the chemical you wish to add in the search field. I will be generating isopropanol liquid waste. Once typed in, click on the search button for a list of possible options. There is isopropanol liquid. Select the radio button and it gets added to the list. The next thing is to enter the amount of the waste and to select the units from the drop-down menu. I have 100 milliliters of isopropanol liquid waste. Note that if you made an error, you can select the remove link and start over. Now we select the container type. Use the drop-down menu to pick it from various options. I have a glass bottle that is 1 liter in size. Note that the system assigns the primary hazard to the items you add to the list. Isopropanol is flammable. You may override this by selecting different or additional hazards by clicking on the appropriate checkboxes. When in doubt, select toxic. To add additional constituents to the label, go back and select the Add button again. Do not mix acids and bases together, and do not mix oxidizers with flammables. Also consider the possibility for other reactions, and always remember to mix only when you are certain of compatibility. My next constituent is some waste gear oil. I enter it just like I did isopropanol, look for it on the list, and select the radio button. And now I can enter the amount in units. Okay. You may also enter comments as you wish. Your comments will appear on the label. Hello, EH&S. I'm using your system. I love it. Okay, now we can enter the number of waste containers. I have one. If you have more than one container, you can enter that amount, and the system will print one label for each container. Since I only have one container, I'm just going to leave the number at one. Now we're ready to save and print. Make sure you select Save and Print from the drop-down menu. When you hit Submit, a screen appears that tells you the tag was saved successfully with the tracking number assigned. to print the label, select the radio box and hit the print label button. A dialog box appears with the PDF of the label. You can now print the label and then affix it to your container using the window envelope provided by EH&S. Okay, that's how you print a label for chemical wastes. Thank you for viewing this presentation.